So we're going to overview what the Bento methodology is and what it can do for you with your productivity and especially task management. Now, just a little disclaimer, the Bento experience and methodology is not about reducing your to-do list. It's actually about prioritizing the tasks that are on your to-do list. So you can happily use this alongside a task management application that you already use and even integrate it into your system. So we're gonna really dive into three core areas of this: pack, flow, and focus, as a way of explaining the Bento experience. Let's dive into the first area, pack. So, as you can imagine, a Bento box is designed into different parts. We've created it so that you can basically organize it as a large, medium, and small task. Large tasks are essentially ones that need deep focus, 90 minutes plus, and are normally quite deliverable orientated. A medium task is more analytical and balanced, needing about 45 to 60 minutes, and are typically project orientated, helping you to work towards a project. And a small task are administrative or well-being related, and need about 15 to 30 minutes, and typically quite light and habitual. Now, each Bento box limits you to just those three tasks, really narrowing you down into paying more attention to what are your core focuses. So you can pick one of them. For example, a large task could be write report, medium task could be maybe manage email campaign, and a small task might be 15 minutes of yoga. So you can also use them to plan weekly, monthly, and yearly, but Bento boxes are great per day. Now moving on to the next part of the process, flow. This is essentially just the order you do them in, and we call this workflow approaches. So, Eat That Frog is a great example of that. You can go from large task to medium to small task. This is really suitable for morning people. Starting with the large task, it's like Eating That Frog, a concept by Brian Tracy that helps you to really jump on the biggest task first. The second, Climb the Mountain. It's a medium to large to small, so you start off with a balanced approach, kicking off with a medium task and then working on the big thing in the middle of the day and finishing off with something small. And finally, the slow burn. This is perfect for those who take a little bit of time to warm up in the morning and get all of their energy and focus in the afternoon. Starting with a small task, you can move to the medium, finish with the last one. So this is great for those who are maybe a little bit more, less of morning people in that sense. So you can select one of these flows to apply to each of your mentor boxes, and you can change it every single day, but you can balance it based on your energy levels. And finally, focus. Basically, having one task in mind is really key as you're doing each of these. So don't jump between tasks. You need to be using deep work, a concept by Cal Newport, to really avoid context switching. Basically, context switching is moving between different apps and tasks and constantly evolving that, and trying to block distractions at the same time. So making sure that notifications aren't pinging and things like that. Setting timers is a great way to really enhance the focus, and using the recommended timer amounts on large, medium, and small tasks is a great way to do that. And you can even combine it with methodologies like the Bento method and using it alongside the Pomodoro timer. So big thanks to Sketchnote Designer for this one, Silly Strokes. It's been a pleasure working with her. If you want to check out some of her stuff, you can find it linked in the description below. But that was the Bento methodology, illustrated and visualized so that you can go and apply it. And again, we've got a tool for it, but you can apply it to any of the different to-do list applications or even note-taking applications that you use on a day-to-day basis. And if you want to enhance your learning on it, we do have a fantastic course that will dive just into that. So folks, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed this dive into the Bento methodology.